In this video, we're going to talk about the Ceka Attachment System, and in particular, Ceka Servicing. When it comes to Ceka servicing?
Well, the Ceka attachment is probably one of the oldest attachments still on the market. Mm. Came out in the 60s. It was the gold standard. Most of the technicians I learned from when I was growing up have Ceka in their own mouse. It's a beautiful system, but there's a lot of moving parts and it can be very intimidating. So we're going to spend some time going through three or four of the questions we get asked the most and trying to make them really easy for this generation of dental technician and dentist to use the system.
Okay, makes a lot of sense. So what's the number one thing that comes up?
Number one thing is replacing the males. And one of the unique things is there's a tool in the Ceka system, A1 tool, has two sides, one for threading the male attachments out of the prosthesis. Mm-hmm. The other side, which is a tapered blade, is used to expand the males.
Okay.
So if the patient comes to you and says, I want a little more retention, you don't need to necessarily replace the males. You can go in with your A1 tool, place it into the cross sections, press it in once, turn it 90 degrees, press it into the other cross section, and you've expanded the male to compensate for wear in the female.
And increase retention along the way.
Absolutely. So you don't necessarily need to replace the males every time to increase retention.
It can just be an adjustment along the way.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So that's a nice simple visit. If you do need to replace the males, you can use the crosshaired portion of the tool to engage the male spring pin that is in the prosthesis. Mm-hmm. The male spring pins all thread into a retention cap, whether the retention cap is retained in acrylic, soldered, or welded. The males simply unthread from the partial denture, put a new male on the end of the A1 tool,
and it's a simple process of screwing it back in.
And you thread it right back into place. Now, there are four different retention levels of these Ceka spring pins. Mm-hmm. The standard spring pin is a 1.88 millimeter diameter. There's a 1.95, a 2.02, and a 2.09 millimeter.
So you have to select the right one to put back into the system.
Yeah, and one of the easy things we've created along the way is a little tool called a Ceka Sizer. It has a number on it. 188, 195, 202, and 209, four little red plastic dummy mock spring pins. Mm-hmm. These are placed directly into the female in the patient's mouth, and it lets you know with a friction test which size is going to give the best fit and best retention. You don't want it to move or wobble. If that's the case, go up to the next size. But you don't want to have your thumb turn purple like your shirt or scrape plastic by pressing too hard.
That makes sense. Sounds like it's much easier chairside to do something like that.
Absolutely. So once you use the Ceka Sizer, figure out exactly what size spring pin you need, simply unthread the new one, thread in the new one, unthread the old one, thread in the new one, and you should be good to go.
All right, terrific. What are some of the other big pieces? I know you mentioned three or four questions that come up from time and time again.
Sure. A lot of the time the prosthesis has been in the mouth for 25, 30 years.
Wow.
Acrylic really isn't meant to be in the mouth that long. What we're going to do is we're going to take the existing prosthesis, we're going to make a new one.
Okay.
This can be done one of two ways. One way is we are going to use a system of transfers and impression copings to provide our laboratory with a master model that they can then work off of. To do so, we again need to use the Ceka Sizer to figure out what size male gives the best fit and best retention. Mm. We're going to create our custom impression coping by taking this male, and again, we're using the A1 tool.
And you've sized that using the special plastic pieces you spoke about.
You got it, the Ceka Sizer. So I'm going to thread the spring pin into the H14 to create my custom impression coping. When I'm seating this into the female attachment that is in the mouth, you'll notice it moves and wobbles.
Right.
This is a common call we get. I use the sizer, but the spring pin feels loose inside the female.
So what's the answer here?
The answer is that the space maintainer was not used. There's a little tiny brass space maintainer that comes with the impression coping. And what the space maintainer is used for is it's used during impression taking, it's used during indirect and direct processing. It elevates the male to keep it in a more retentive position. There's a concave-convex relationship between the male and female. This elevates the male, and also with the thickness of the spacer, 0.3 millimeter, you're allowing the patient to function, to chew, to swallow, without having the attachment mushroom out inside the female. It's allowing that vertical movement. So ideally, if we were going to take an impression, again, we have our 694C threaded into the impression coping. Here's our little space maintainer. Mm-hmm. And the space maintainer is difficult to work with in the mouth sometimes. I would take a little dab of petroleum jelly, put it on the head of the spring pin.
And that kind of keeps it in there?
Exactly. And then snap my impression coping into place.
And now it's feeling solid.
You can see how firm and solid that is.
Yeah.
This would be picked up in a new impression by the clinician. Again, keeping the space maintainer in place. The laboratory is going to snap the female analog into place, re-index that into the impression, so when the cast is poured up and separated, the H13 analog is going to be in the mouth exactly where the female attachment is.
That makes a lot of sense.
Now, there's one catch to this when we're talking about servicing. If we have a case where there's wear on the attachment and we're using a size 202 spring pin, for example, this 202 will not be able to snap into this H13. This H13 analog will only take a 188.
Okay.
It's much too large. You'll go crazy trying to push it in.
Right.
If that's the case, unthread the oversized, the 202 pin, thread in a standard or a working pin. H1 is a working pin, thread in a working pin. Then you can snap it into place and go forward with the impression pouring up technique.
So you just use that 1.88, if I'm saying that right, just for the sort of the working part of that process.
Correct. So if the patient needs a 195 or a 202 or a 209, a lot of the time my instructions to the clinician will be use the oversized pin for the impression, unthread it from the impression coping, put it in a bag and put it in the patient's chart. The laboratory is going to use either the H1 or the 188 during the rest of the procedures.
Okay, I can see how that would solve that problem. Excellent. So are there any other big pieces that come up when we're talking about Ceka servicing?
Sure. The other one would be if we wanted to reline this partial denture. And again, this is a case where using this 694B, the little spacer, is extremely important. I'm going to take the existing prosthesis with the attachments in place. I'm going to place that little space maintainer over the attachments. So when I go to take my washer reline impression, I have the space maintainers in place. Again, a little dab of petroleum jelly helps hold them into place. Mm-hmm. So when I'm taking my washer reline impression, I position the attachments in that resilient position.
And so that's nice and firm.
Exactly. So it's going to give the correct position of the attachments when we're relining and adding acrylic to compensate for the lost bone in the saddle area.
So that's a lot of information about Ceka servicing. That's three or four things at least. Any other big chunks that I need to know?
Chairside pickup.
Okay.
So a lot of the times, chairside pickup is going to be the easiest way to pick up a Ceka attachment. If we're doing that, again, we're going to want to use permablock. We're going to want to block out the undercut. And again, there's two different designs of the Ceka females. One came off the crown at 90 degrees. The second series came off at 30, 45, or 60, but there's still an undercut that we want to block out. Next is we're going to take our spring pin, the appropriate size. We've used that Ceka Sizer, and we are going to thread the spring pin into the retention cap. For acrylic processing chairside, it looks like a frying pan, for lack of a better term.
Oh, yeah.
Has a little tail on it. You can cut the tail if you're fighting for space. You don't want to bend the tail though. What can happen if you try and bend the tail? It can warp the inner threads. So we have our spring pin threaded into the retention cap. And again, just like before, if I snap this into place, there's a lot of movement, it wobbles.
So I'm guessing you're about to talk to me about the spacer again.
That's correct. I'm going to take the spacer. Place the spacer over. Again, I'm going to put a little dab of petroleum jelly on the tip of the space maintainer or the spring pin. It's going to hold the spacer in place, as well as if there is any excess acrylic resin that gets near the attachment, it will not lock onto the attachment because of the petroleum jelly. Mm. I'm going to snap this into place.
And now?
Firm, solid, and now I'm ready to go forward with my regular pickup technique. The one thing in particular when you're dealing with a chairside pickup of an edentulous patient like this, or I'm sorry, of a patient who is edentulous in the posterior, where it's all tissue supported, you don't want to have the patient bite down and can't or rotate the prosthesis. Finger pressure over the attachment area. Again, you don't want the patient to come into full occlusion of the posterior and cause the prosthesis to can't or rotate up because of the compression of the posterior tissue.
All right, that's a whole lot of information. Any other big chunks of Ceka servicing, or have we covered those top five?
I think we pretty much covered the top five questions we get.
All right, if you'd like more information, please head over to Preat.com, where there's lots of knowledge and information. Of course, you can order all of these parts. There are hundreds, it turns out, of case presentations, as well as the product book. And, of course, you can order everything and get technical support, customer support, through the phone number, through email, and through the contact page. Thanks very much, and I'll see you over at Preat.com.